Okay, so now let's discuss, and then we're going to go ahead and demonstrate Splunk Enterprise installation on Windows. The first thing we're going to go here, when you go to Splunk again, access your free trials and go to Splunk Enterprise, you have to go to this tab with Windows, which is going to show you the .msi package. That's the package that you have to download. So the next step you have to do is just download that .msi package into your local machine. And when you download, it's going to give you that package, which is going to look like what you have here on the right. So what's the next thing you have to do? Basically, installing Splunk on Windows is straightforward. It's just like any other software that you want to install on your laptop. So all you need to go and do is to double click that package, and it's going to start the Splunk installation wizard, which looks like what you have here on the bottom. And this is the wizard that is going to guide you through the process of Splunk installation. Now, what are some of the things that are going to happen during that installation? You're going to have to accept the license agreement. So we just saw that the trial package comes with its own license, which is limited to 500 megabytes a day. And, you know, 60 days of all features open for you, amongst other things. So you have to accept the license agreement. The second thing, now you just have to click start, and then it's going to start installing Splunk for you. It's going to take a while to do that. During that process, you will need to specify a username and password for Splunk administrator user. So when you install Splunk, ultimately you're going to have to log into Splunk. The username and password that you use to log into Splunk, you have to specify that at the time of installation, and that become the admin credentials for the instance that you just installed. Now, after you install Splunk, there are some post-installation steps that you need to take to make sure that Splunk is functioning correctly without any interruptions. The first thing you have to do is to start Splunk Enterprise. And to start Splunk Enterprise, you need to use the command prompt. So when you go to the command prompt, then you're going to have to navigate to program files Splunk/bin. Now, program files as Splunk is the folder where Splunk is installed on Windows. When you install Splunk on Windows, Splunk is going to live in program files Splunk, and you're going to always see this referred to as Splunk home. When we speak about Linux, or maybe when we discuss Linux and Mac OS, you're going to see that the installation directory is different. So in order to start Splunk, you have to navigate into that installation directory. So you go to program files Splunk, and then you navigate into the bin directory. So the bin directory or folder is what contains the Splunk binary. So the Splunk binary basically can listen to commands. So you can pass commands to the Splunk binary to perform actions in Splunk. Now, how do you start Splunk using that Splunk binary? You can go into the Splunk binary. You're going to see splunk.exe that you can use there. So you just basically use the command splunk start, and then it's going to start Splunk for you. So we're going to see that in the demonstration. Now, after Splunk is started, what you want to do is to log into Splunk. So when you install a software on your machine, you want to use it. So basically with Splunk, you have installed it, you have started it, and now you want to use it. So in order to use it, you have to log in. So you have to log into Splunk Web. Now, what is the first thing? The default login port for Splunk is port 8000. So when you install Splunk on a local machine, like your laptop, this port 8000 is automatically open for you. So you can log into your instance. When you install Splunk on a remote instance, maybe like an EC2 instance or from AWS as we saw, or maybe a Microsoft Azure virtual machine, that port 8000, you have to enable it. You have to make sure that on your firewall or security group, port 8000 is open, because your login is going to be remote because your machine is in the cloud. So you have to enable that. But locally, you don't have to do anything. So how do you log into the instance? All you need to do is to specify it this way: HTTP, localhost, and then you put the port number. As I said, the default port is 8000. This localhost, you can specify it if your instance is installed on your local machine, such as your laptop. But if it's remote, then you have to replace this with the IP address of that remote instance. And then what are you going to do next now? So when you're going to do this, it will show you, after you do the HTTP login, it's going to show you like what we have here. So it's going to give you the login prompt. And now on that login prompt, you need a username and password in order to log into your Splunk Web. So what are you going to do? You have to now provide the username and password that we configured during installation, and then you're going to be able to log into the instance of Splunk that you've just installed on Windows. And then what I'm going to do, I think I'll just type Splunk free trials and downloads, right, like we saw. If I do this, then you see I have free trials and downloads here, which is going to connect me to the Splunk website, as we saw, right? So when it takes me there, let's see what we get. All right, we get Splunk Enterprise here. We're not going to talk about Splunk Cloud. We didn't speak about that in the theory. So we're going to talk about Splunk Enterprise and the Universal Forwarder, right? This is the Splunk Enterprise trial package that we want to install. And remember that when we were discussing these Splunk components, we said that the Universal Forwarder was also available as a separate executable. So you can also get a free version of the Universal Forwarder and maybe install on your host machine if you wanted to collect some kind of data and send to your Splunk. Right, so what we are interested here is the Splunk Enterprise trial version. So we're going to click on here. And now what it's going to do is ask us to, like, we have to create an account. Remember, we saw this. So you have to fill up all this, accept the agreement, and then create an account in Splunk, right? That's pretty straightforward. But since I already have an account, what I'm going to do here is just to log in. So now it's logging me in. And now that I'm logged in, you see that I can have exactly the same window that we saw before, right? When we were discussing the theory. Now we are on version 9.1.0.2. And then you see that on the Windows, you have the MSI package. That's the one we are interested in. If you go to Linux, you're going to see three of them as we discuss. We're going to come to this when we are installing on Linux. And then, of course, Mac OS, you have the GUI installation and the CLI installation. So what we're interested now in is Windows. So we're going to download this .msi package here. I'm just going to click on it. It's going to take some time to download here. So my MSI package now is completely downloaded, as you can see here. And if I go to the downloads folder, I can access my package. This is a Splunk package. So I'm just going to double click on it, as we said. And then it's going to open the startup wizard for me to start installing Splunk. All right. So the first thing, again, remember we said that when you are installing Splunk on Windows, you're going to have to accept the license agreement, right? Here it says view license. So if you want, you can read the entire text of the license by clicking here, but I'm just going to check this box to accept the license agreement. And then here it tells us that it's going to install in the Splunk home that we saw for Windows, right, which is program files-splunk. And then I'm just going to take next here. And then now this is where you're going to put those credentials that we were talking about that you're going to use to log into your Splunk instance as an admin. So let me just put a username and password here. All right. Oops, sorry. All right. So when I do that now, it says create a shortcut menu. I'm just going to click on install here. So you see that it starts installing Splunk Enterprise for you on Windows, right? I'm going to pause this and we'll be back when Splunk is installed. All right, so Splunk Enterprise is completely installed. And as you can see here, it was installed successfully. And it's saying that it will launch a browser with Splunk Enterprise, right? So I can just click on finish here. Right, so I'm just going to, you know, just once launch this. Right, I'm just going to close this out, okay? We're not going to use this one right now. But we said that for the post-installation steps, you want to start Splunk, right? And then you want to enable bootstrap. But we said that for Windows, bootstrap is enabled by default. So you really don't have to do that, right? And then the third thing, now after that, we're going to go ahead and log into Splunk using this browser. So to start Splunk, we just go to command prompt here. And then I'm going to open that as administrator. Okay. All right. Let's take yes here. It opens that for me, right? So what I'm going to do is that I'm going to change my directory to C. Then I'm going to go to program files. And then Splunk. Okay, so it takes me there, right? If I do this, you see, like, in there, you're going to have the bin folder, which is where you have your Splunk binary, right? So I can go into bin, and then I'm going to have that. So I'm now in program file Splunk bin. So from here, I can do start Splunk. So now Splunk has been started. And so what we're going to do now is to go ahead and log into the Splunk Web UI, right? So I'm just going to go here. And as we said, I've installed this on my laptop. So this is a local host, right? I'm just going to put HTTP. Then I'm going to put localhost, and then we set port 8000 when you install in local machine is open, right? I'm going to do that. And then let's see what happens. So it puts me on the login prompt, right? At this point, I'm just going to now use those credentials that I configured during installation in order to log into my instance. Yep, there we go. So I'm logged into my Splunk instances now. I just installed on Windows. I'm successfully logged in like the admin. So we're going to have, a module where we're going to speak about the Splunk Web UI. So we're not going to go into the details of all this now. So that's the end of this demo.